Hey guys, it's me Tariq Akhtar Ansari. In this video, we are going to learn about how we can host WordPress application in AWS server. So here I'm going to use EC2 instance for hosting. Okay, so the first and most important thing, you need one active account of AWS. So here I have one account. I'm going to log in with this account. Okay. Now, AWS offers many services. As of now, we are going to use compute service, and under the compute sections, we need EC2 instance. Okay, so click here on EC2. Now click here running instance. We don't have any running instance, zero. Click here. Then click on launch instance. You can launch as many as instance you want, but as of now, we want only one instance. Okay, then click on launch. Then click on AWS Marketplace and search for WordPress. You will get lots of options, but the first one is the best one. You can go with this option. Okay. So here you just need to continue. Don't be worried about any charges. Just go down and click on continue. This instance is available on free tier. It means it will be free. Okay, you don't need to pay any charges for this. Just click on T2 Micro. Okay, then click on next configure. Here only the changes you need to do. Click on auto assign public IP, enable it, and then click on next, add storage. Here you can increase your size, you can add additional volume, but I'm going with the default option. I'm not going to change anything. Just click on add tag. Here I'm not going to do anything. I'm just clicking on next, configure security group. Here make sure at least you are exposing three port, 2280 and 443. So these are the mandatory. If you want additional port, like if you are using any database, you want to expose their port number, you can, but at least these are the minimum requirement. You need to expose these three port. Okay, then only we can connect FTP, HTTP and HTTPS. Then click on review and launch. And just check once and click on launch. Now here you need to generate a private key. So using this key, we can connect with our instance. If you're doing first time, then you need to generate a new key. You need to choose name here. Then you can download this key and make sure you keep this file very safe, because this is private key. And you can use this to connect with your instance. Okay, now here you can see that I have downloaded prabhat.pam file. I'll use this to connect with my instance. Okay, in future using PuTTY. As of now, just click on launch instance and it will take a little bit of time. Once you'll get this message, then click on view instance. Here you can see our instance is running, but still initializing process is not yet finished. So we need to keep patience to finish all this initializing process. Once it is finished, then we can go for next. Now here you can see our initializing process is finished. Now just copy IPv4 address. So copy this IPv4 address, open a new tab and paste here. Now our WordPress application is launched, but we are accessing using IP address. Now go to admin side using /wp-admin. Now here our username will be user and password will be our instance. We will get that password from our instance log. Just select instance and click on action. Go to system setting and get system log. Then scroll down, you will find password in this log. Okay, so here you can see our password is here. Okay, just copy this password. Copy. Okay, now paste here. Click on login. Now you can see we have successfully launched our WordPress application. Now we need DNS management system so that we can connect EC2 instance with domain name. AWS provide one more service, Route 53. Using that, we can connect a domain name with EC2 instance. So we can search here Route 53. Click this one. Now create hosted zone. Click here. We have other option as well, but DNS management under this, click here, create hosted zone. Now here you need to give your domain name. So in my case, my domain name is dreadbots.in. Paste here. Now description is optional, so I'm leaving it default. Now make sure you have checked public hosted zone, then click on create hosted zone. Now we need to define records. So click here, create record. Now choose here simple routing. Click on next. Then click on define simple record. We will define two record, A record and CNAME. So first column, leave it as blank. Then choose here first option, IP address or another value depending on the record type. Choose this option. Okay. Then paste the IP address here of your instance. So here, this is my IP address of the instance. So I'm copying here. Now paste here. Now make sure you have selected A record type. Then click on define simple record. Okay. Now we need one more record. This time we need record type CNAME. Now enter here www and select here first option IP address. Okay. Then this time paste your domain name. Okay. That's it. Remove white spaces. And then click on define simple record. Click on create records. That's it. Now here you can see, just let me clear all this so we can see more spaces. So now here you can see we have NS namespaces. So we need to copy this namespace from here to our domain name provider. So in my case, my domain name provider is GoDaddy. So go to your domain name, my domains. Go to DNS management, manage DNS. So here we need to update the name server of AWS. So we need to change this name server with AWS name server. So click on change and update one by one all the name server of AWS. Okay, make sure you don't copy dot at the end. So just copy the name. So here I'm pasting the second. So one by one, I'll copy all the name here. Then click on save. It will ask for confirmation. Just check the yes and click on continue button. Now we need to keep patience. It will take 4 to 6 hours to update your domain name. So I have waited for 6 hours. Then I come back. Now you can see my domain name is updated. So at least you need to wait for 6 hours. Okay. To update your domain name. Otherwise you will see your domain name will not get updated. Now the next thing is, we are going to remove this logo from here first, then we will update HTTPS. We'll make our site secure. So click on logo itself, then scroll down. You will find here disable the page. Click here. Now here you will get the command to disable that logo. Okay, copy this command. So here I'm going to save this command in our notepad first. Then you will get the second command to restart the server. Okay. Paste here. Now here you can see in the first command app name, you need to replace this app name with your app. So in my case, my app name is WordPress. Okay. For executing command in your instance, you need a PuTTY software. Using that, you can connect to your EC2 instance and then you can execute command in PuTTY. Okay. So it's very easy. You can do just couple of next, then you can install PuTTY. We have installed PuTTY successfully. PuTTY comes with PuTTY Gen. This software is used to convert .pam file into .ppk file. So we use ppk file to connect PuTTY with EC2 instance. Okay. First load your ppk file wherever you have download. So in my case, my download file is inside F drive. Tarik folder, then new folder. So here I'll select my PAM file. First you need to change here all types, then select your PAM file. So in my case prabhat.pam, then it will ask OK, then click on save private key, then click on yes. Now you need to save this file in any location. So I'm saving this file in document with the same name prabhat.ppk. You can see here prabhat.pam. So here I'm converting this to prabhat.ppk. So just write prabhat there, automatically it will save in .ppk format. For your confirmations, you can check directly in physical location. Here you can see that prabhat.ppk file is generated. Okay, now we can open PuTTY software. This time we need to open PuTTY. Now here we need to do couple of things. First, here you can copy this IP address of your instance, paste here, give a name to this connection. So here I'm giving dreadbots, so it will be easy to recall next time. Then click on save. Here you can see dreadbots. Now we need to do more things. We need to do the SSH connection. For that we will use auth, data and tunnel. Okay, we'll do the three things. So first click on auth. Here load your PPK file which we have just generated. That's it. Then click on data, pass here your username. So our username is Bitnami because we have created Bitnami instance. Maybe it could be Ubuntu and other name as well, but in my case it is Bitnami. Okay, click on tunnel. So tunnel, what does it create? A tunnel between EC2 instance and our local. So here I'm going to connect EC2 instance local 80 port number with our port 888888. So we can access localhost 888. So it will access EC2 instance local port as well. Okay, just click on dreadbots and click on save. So it will save all the settings. Then click on open. Okay, so we have, it will ask for yes, just do the yes. So we have connected PuTTY with our instance and we have also created tunnel. Now we are ready to execute commands in our EC2 instance terminal. First do ls, you will find apps folder. Just go to app folder, cd apps. Now here do ls. Here you can see that our application name is WordPress. So the command which we have copied for removing logo from our applications, this one. Now here replace the app name with our app's name. Now copy this whole command from here and execute in our EC2 instance terminal. Hit enter. Executed successfully. Now let's check first our application logo removed or not. So it's removed. We don't need to restart app server. Now the next thing, we need to make it secure, HTTPS. For making HTTP secure, we need to execute this command. Don't be worried, I'll give this command in my descriptions. You can copy from there. When you will execute this command, it will ask few questions. You need to answer one by one. The first thing, it will ask for domain list. Here you need to add your all domain name. In my case, my domain name is dreadbots.in. So we can add dreadbots.in, www.dreadbots.in. And in this way, we can provide the list of domain. But I will show how we can do that. So here let me add my domain first, dreadbots.in. That's it, I'm doing. When I hit enter, it will ask the following domain were not included, www.dreadbots.in. Do you want to add them? Yes. Enable HTTP to HTTPS redirection? Yes. So it will redirect all HTTP call to HTTPS. Enable none www to www redirection? Here I'll do no. Now again it's asking enable www to none www redirection. Again I'll do no. Whether they will type www or none www doesn't matter for me. Do you agree to their changes? Do yes here. Now here you just need to enter your email address. So here I'm just giving info@dreadbots.in. Do you agree? Let's encrypt. Yes. It's take little bit of time. Now hit enter to continue. So we have almost done. Now we can check. In Chrome you may can't see the reflection immediately because it do caching. So first we will open incognito mode where we will check. Here type redbots.in and see. So now here you can see that our site is secure. You can see the lock icon here. Now in our Chrome, just close the existing tab and open a new tab to see the reflection. Now here you can see that our site is secure. Now we can go to the admin panel as well, /wp-admin. Username is user and password we can get from our system log. So this is my password, paste here. Now here you can see everything is working fine. The only thing is left FTP setup so that we can transfer file to server. We can download from there. For FTP, I'm going to use a software, FileZilla. I have already downloaded and installed. If you haven't, I have given the link in the description so you can check out. Now click here on file menu, click on site manager, then click here new site. Now here you need to paste your IP address of your EC2 instance. Copy this IP address from here, paste here. Port 22 we will use and protocol we are going to use SFTP. Okay, now login type will be key file. Okay, here give username bitnami and choose your .ppk file, browse here. Okay, just click on connect. Now you can see we have connected successfully. This side you can see all the servers file and folder. So apps folder here you can see inside that WordPress. Now we can upload all the files. So in the next video I will show you how we can migrate our existing server with database to AWS. Whether you have hosted in GoDaddy, GoViral Webhost, any hosting server, we will directly migrate with all these things in the next video. Please watch this video and don't forget to subscribe my channel so that I can do more videos such kind of. Thanks for watching this video.